ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥಾರ್ಯ ಕವಿತಾರ್ಕೆ ಕೇಸರಿ ವೇದಾಂತ ಆಚಾರ್ಯವರ್ಯೋ ಮೇ ಸನ್ನಿಧತ್ತಾಂ ಸದಾ ಹೃದಿ. ನಮೋ ನಾರಾಯಣ. ಕುಲಶೇಖರ ಆಳ್ವಾರ್ ದಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪೇಯ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಒಬೇಸನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ತುತಿ ಆನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಮ್ಸ್. ಏಷ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ಕ್ಷೀರಾರ್ಣವ ನಿಕೇತನ ನಾಗಪರ್ಯಂಕಮುತ್ಸೃಜ್ಯ ಹ್ಯಾಗತೋ ಮಧುರಾಂ ಪುರಿಂ, ವಿಚ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮೀಪತಿ ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದ ಮಿಲ್ಕಿ ಓಷನ್ ದ ತಿರುಪ್ಪಾರ್ ಕಡಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಸಸ್ಥಾನಂ as the place of his residence along with Mahalakshmi, reclining on the Adisheshan on the white milky ocean, and he is there. He has discarded that such a blissful place, and he has appeared in Madhurapuri as Sri Krishna. ಯೇಷ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ಕ್ಷೀರಾರ್ಣವ ನಿಕೇತನ ನಾಗಪರ್ಯಂಕ ಮುತ್ಸೃಜ್ಯ ಹ್ಯಾಗತೋ ಮಧುರಾಂ ಪುರಿಂ. ಸಚ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾಷನೇಟ್ ದಯಾಳು ಪರಮದಯಾಳು ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಅವತಾರಂ ಆಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಧ್ಯಾನಂ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಕುಲಶೇಖರ ಆಳ್ವಾರ್ ಇನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ಮುಕುಂದಮಾಲಾ. And Namalvar also says, Maname unnai valvinayen irandhe small ra. Maname unnai valvinayen, this incorrigible Mahapapi, he is pleading you, O mind, please perform dhyanam, meditate on Krishna. And that is what he is doing now in this, looking at Lord Sri Ranganatha. In front of him, in looking at Sri Ranganathan in Sri Rangam on Adisheshan, he is thinking of Kshirarnava, Kshirasagara, Taranga, Sikara, Sara, Tarakita, Charu, Murtaye, Bogi Boga, Shayaniya, Shayine, Madhavaya, Madhavid Vishenamaha. The 39th verse of Kulasegar Alvar, which is today's verse. Here the Alvar visualizes the Paramapada Nathan at his other abode, which is the Milky Ocean or Kshirabdi Nathan. So the association of Vaikuntha Nathan resting on Adisheshan comes to Alvar's mind on Milky Ocean when he is standing before Sri Ranganatha at Bhuloka Vaikuntham, Sri Rangam. So before enjoying the verse, one needs to know that when a person is thirsty and wants to drink water, he would naturally go in for the water which is nearby, which is easily accessible. So our acharyas say that param, paramapadam, is like the water which is lying beyond the cosmos, completely inaccessible for us to humans, avarana jalam, the enveloping waters, the pralaya jalam, vyuhavataram is this kshirasagaram or the milky ocean that could only be imagined or visualized by us but cannot be accessed or obtained now in this birth as humans. And vibhavam is like the heavy kattaru, torrential, turbulent, heavy waters during the heavy rains. The rivers are full of floods and now it is completely drought. There is nothing. There is no rain nor floods, nothing. So where are those waters which were originally at that time when there were floods? Like the Kattaru, the turbulent waters are not available now. So the Vibhava avataram, Ramakrishna avataram happened and people enjoyed at that time, not now. They don't come and walk in front of us, steal butter or perform rasa krida in front of us. No, we can only imagine. So that is Vibhava avataram. Antaryami avataram, Antaryami rupam, in the cavity of our hearts, is like the underground water which needs to be drilled and have a bore well and has to be sucked out and can be done only by the yogis and rishis, as we saw in the previous verse, controlling the mind. So that's the utrajalam, underground water, cannot be reached without any effort from us. Effort is 100 kilometers away from me. Archavatara, Lord Ranganatha, Tirumalai Srinivasan, Varadan, Triplicane, Parthasarathi, Melkote, all this Swayam Vyakta Kshetram or Divya Kshetram or Arsha Kshetram consecrated by rishis or Manusha Kshetram constructed by humans according to Agama Sastras, whether it is Swayam Vyaktam like Trivenkatam or Srirangam or Badrikashramam, Naimisharanyam, Shaligramam, Srimushnam, Pushkaram, Jagannath Puri, whatever, these Kshetrams are Swayam Vyakta Kshetrams, or Divya Kshetram, Kanchipuram, established by Devas, Trivannagaram, Triplicane, Trinarayur, these are the ones established by Devas or Siddhas. Arsha Kshetram consecrated by rishis, Manusha Kshetram by humans according to Agama Sastras, whether it is Pancharatram or Vaikhanasam. So the Archavataram are absolutely no different between the other forms. In fact, Archavataram is even sweeter than other forms, because here it's like the infant to whom we give shower, dry him up, smear him with sandal paste, bedeck him with flowers, ornaments, dressing him up with silk, pitambaram, costly garments, feed him with milk, honey, fruits, food, akkaravadisal, butter, all done in loving devotion, bhakti. So the Lord is a silent partner to whatever that bhakta does, well or ill, never complaining, ever accepting the service and the bathing of the devotee. So the simplicity and accessibility of Perumal in Shaligramam at our home, or the Divyamangala Vigraham in the temple, it sits in vibration in the heart of the bhakta. Thereby the bhakta feels that he is being transported emotionally to the divine presence, and that bliss is making him yearn and waiting for the reaching Paramapadam. In such worship, God comes down from the beyond to within such a relationship. Tamaruhanda devuruvam avuruvam tane. So going into this verse, Chirasagara Taranga Shikara Chara Tarakita Charu Murtaye Bogi Boga Shayaniya Shayine Madhavaya Madhavid Vishenamaha Madhavaya Madhavid Vishenamaha. He offers his pranamams, salutations, worshipping to the killer, or the one who removed Madhu, Asuran, Madhu Kaitapan, thus removing the obstacles for us. And he is Madhavan, none other than Madhavan, Sriyapati, Lord of Sridevi, divine consort of Mahalakshmi, Periya Pirati. So Alvar visualizes this Sriyapati Madhavan at Sriranga Kshetram as the one who is resting on Adisheshan, and Chirasagara in this Chirabdi, Chiram, milky version, Taranga Shikara Sara. Just visualize yourself. You are in front of the white, vast, deep, completely white, pure white, milky ocean, not blue ocean, milky ocean. And on that white, there is a further white, large, huge Adisheshan, reclining with the with its head, and on that you see a divine, majestic, exquisitely beautiful, Tejasvi, dark blue hued Perumal Sriman Narayana reclining along with Mahalakshmi. And in that blue hued form and the Pitambaram, the bare chest, because he is reclining, he will not have all those ornaments, and while he goes to recline, it would bare the chest, and one can enjoy the majestic strong shoulders and the beauty of the chest. And on that, Alvar visualizes looking at Ranganathan, the Milky Ocean, where Tarakita Charu Murtaye, in that beautiful Trimeni Divyamangala Vigraham, Tarakita, the ocean, the Milky Ocean, has got the tide which splashes on his body, because it hits on the Adhisheshan and it raises, and the milk particles sprinkle on the body. When it sprinkles, the white particles that is sprinkled or splashed on his body gently, he is like the star in the blue hued sky, the dark blue sky. So the sky on which you see the stars, similarly Perumal's Divya Trimeni is with the stars, the milky droplets on the Trimeni. So Bogi Boga Shayaniya Shayine, he is closing his eyes, having his Yoga Nidra on the Trivalan Thalvan Trimeni. And we see the beauty when somebody is sleeping, eyes closed, we can enjoy the Trimeni of theirs, because they are not seeing us. So we can enjoy the beauty, and one can enjoy the beauty of Perumal with his eyes closed. And he is that Sri Apati, and I perform my Namaskaram, says Alvar. Such a beautiful vision and visual beauty, and Alvar cries out in ecstasy over the beautiful vision when he sees the beautiful blue hued body, Trimeni Divyamangala Vigraham, in the Kshirabdi Nathan, and the drops of milk resembling the brilliant white shining star specks. It completely thrills the Alvar, and he cries out in intense enjoyment and bliss. It's less said the better. Enough said. You also enjoy. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கே கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரவரியோ மே சனிதத்தாம் சதாகிருதி. திஸ் இஸ் த 40th வர்ஸ் ஆஃப் முகுந்தமாலா, த லாஸ்ட் கன்க்ளூடிங் வர்ஸ் நிகமனம். சுவாமி குலசேகர ஆழ்வார் பிரின்ஸ் ஹிஸ் நேம் ஆஸ் அன் ஆதர்ஷிப் அண்ட் ஸ்டாம்ப் in this verse. Yasya priyau shruti dharau kaviloka veerau mitrau dvijanmavara parashavava bhutam tenam bujaksha sharanam bujashat padena ragnya krita kritiriyam kulashekharena. Here there is another line which says, Yasya priyau shruti dharau kaviloka veerau mitre dvijanmavara padma sharava bhutam. In this final and 40th verse of Mukundamala, Sri Kulasekara Alvar puts the stamp of his authorship, and here he mentions his friendship he acknowledges to two Bhagavatas, Dvijanmavarar Padmasharar, two people, Mitrav, friends, Dvijanmavara Padmashara Bhutam. So Dvijanmavara is one name, Padmasara is another name. And the reference to his friends has caused some doubts on people as whether Kulasekar Alvar has really authored Mukundamala. There is a school of thought that maybe it's a work of another king by name Kulasekara, who lived many years after the Alvar. And there are several interpretations of the line Mitre Dvijanma Vara Padma Sarava Bhutan. Some interpret that Dvijanmavara is one name and Padmavara is another name. Padmasara is another name. The friends, two dear friends, Bhagavatas, scholars, and they are the friends of Kulasekara, because of whom Kulasekara Alvar had this bhakti for Perumal. Others have interpreted that the two noble Dvijanmavara is Brahmins. The Dvijanmavara, the Brahmins, who are two, one is Padma, other is Sara, Padman and Saran, two people. So there is also a good view that this Padmasara refers to Nammalvar and Periyalvar, who appeared before and after Kulasekara Alvar. In this interpretation, Dvijanma refers to Periyalvar, who appeared as a Brahmin. The term Padmasara refers to Nammalvar, the one with the flower, Vagulabharanar, and Maran Shatakopan is a name. So one can equate the term Padmasaran with Sri Nammalvar, who preceded Kulasekara Alvar. So in spite of all these different schools of thought, it is generally viewed and opined by Bhagavatottamas over the years, centuries, that Sri Kulasekara Alvar is the true author of the splendid, divine, majestic verses, 40 verses called Mukundamala, and with the Paramabhakti for Sri Ranganatha. So yasya yadaru, the one Kulasekara Alvar, Shruti Dharav, the one who knows Vedanta Arthams, Kaviloka Virav, the highest among the poets, Dvijanmavara Padmasarav, Dvijanmavara Padmasarav, the two names, Priyav Mitrav, the snehidar, friends, Abhutan, the one for whom there are these Vedic scholar and poet friends, Ambujakcha Sharanambuda Shatpadena, the one who is like a bee at the lotus feet of Pundarikakshan, the red lotus eyed lord, Sriman Narayana, Tena Kulasekarena, Ajna, that Kulasekara Raja, Iyam Kriti Krita, this Grantham has been composed by Kulasekara, whose friends are these Vedic scholars and the highest among poets. So the Kulasekara Alvar, it goes to say that he is the one who composed, and he is one of the greatest proponents of Nama Siddhantam, Nama Sankirtanam. And he has very beautifully talked about this Naman, Nama Sankirtanam and Bhajanam approach for reaching the abode of the Lord. So Bhagavat Adi Purushasya Narayanasya Namocharana Matrena Nirdutakalir Bhavati. In the doctrine of Nama Siddhantam, described in Kalisantaranopanishad, Sri Narada, Sage Narada asked Chaturmukha Brahma, what's the name that enables one to cross the samsaric ocean in Kali Yuga? Brahma immediately responds, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. The recital of the names Rama, Hari and Krishna are the effective names, means to overcome the Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga's influence.
Sri Kulasekara Azhvar advises the same, following this Chaturmukha Brahma, and mentions in Mukundamala exactly, and he says, Govinda Damodara Madhavedi Vaktum Samartopi Navakti Kaschit Ahojanana Vyasanabhi Mukhyam. What a wonder that people are looking at the lowliest worldly pleasure and materialistic pursuits, and they are stuck on that in spite of the grief and sorrow that it gives. And Vishnu Puranam also mentions the same. Marchoma Yajushtata Ma Sama Pata Kinchana Govindeti Harenama Gayam Gayatva Nityashaha Narayaneti Sabdhosti Vagasti Vachavartini Tatapi Narake Gore Patanti Tiet Adbutam. Vishnu Puranam mentions, one need not recite Rig Yajur Samavedam for salvation. One should recite the Nama Sankirtana. One should recite the Lord's names. There is a tongue which is under one's control. In spite of all this easy accessibility, easy utterance, men still fall into hell without uttering these names. What a wonder. Just in line with Kulasekara Azhvar's verse number 37. And Prahlada replies to Hiranyakashipu that what's the best lesson he learnt in school. He says, Sravanam Kirtanam Vishno Smaranam Padashevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakyam Atmanivedanam Iti Pumsar Pita Vishno Bhaktischen Navalakshana Kriyate Bhagavatyadha Tanmaye Dita Muttamam. So I consider as the best lesson worthy of learning is the 9 lakshanam man practices in Vishnu Bhakti. Shravanam, listening to Kalyana Gunams of Perumal. Kirtanam, singing of the Lord. Smaranam, contemplation, remembrance, meditation of Perumal. Padasevanam, Tiruvaradhanam, worshipping his lotus feet. Vandanam, performing salutations. Archanam, archaning with flowers, tulasi leaves. Dasyam, offering service, Bhagavat Kainkarya to him. Sakyam, associating with him as a mitran, shaka, friend. He is apat shaka. Atmanivedanam, surrendering to him completely with unflinching faith. So Sri Kulasekara Azhvar, Mukundamala are just talk about this Navalakshana Bhakti. He mentioned Jihve Kirtaya Keshavam. He also mentions in the verse 18, Namo Narayane Tyamum Mantram Sapranavam Pranama Sahitam Pravartavadhyam Muhuhu. Sri Kulasekara Azhvar requests Ranganatha for unfailing memory, smaranam of his lotus feet, padasevanam, in all janmams, are other examples of practicing Navalakshana Bhakti. He mentions about Dasya Bhakti, Tvad Bhritya Bhritya Paricharaka Bhritya Bhritya Bhrityasya Bhritya Itimam Smaraloka Natha. So he mentions about his Kirtanam, Pravartya Pranjalerasmi Jihve Namani Narayana Gocharani in the verse 30. And in the thus in all the beautiful verses of Mukundamala, we very much see Kulasekara Azhvar's Navalakshana Bhakti, which is celebrated in Srimad Bhagavatam. Sri Kulasekara Azhvar thus sets an example for us to practice the simple means of Navalakshana Bhakti, so that we can get closer to the lotus feet of Sri Vaikunthanathan and enjoy the absolute eternal bliss here as well as there. So it is Adiyan's fortune, bhagyam, opportunity to
have this wonderful association with Mukundamala, get to know that, and in spite of my lack of qualifications in all languages, including Sanskrit, English, Tamil, I offer my humble pranamams and to the most wonderful Vyakyata, Sri Tirumalai Nambi Chaturvedam Shatakritu Chinnama Rangachar Swami, who has blessed us with this great, deep, intense commentary on Mukundamala, which Adiyan has closely followed. And also Swami Sri Opiliyappan Kovil Varadachari Satagopan, who has written a brilliant English translation as well, which I, Adiyan, had reproduced at several occasions. May the divine couple shower their choicest blessings on all of us. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashalini Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Sarvam Sri Krishnarpanamartu Kulasekara Alvar Trivedikale Sharanam Namo Narayana Adiyan.